Our worship is about to begin, so let us quiet our hearts to receive our Lord. Gracious and loving God,
We gather here today from our own small worlds to be united in our worship of you. We're here because of your love demonstrated supremely in Christ. Your grace binds us in fellowship, and your Spirit makes this gathering a communion of faith. Fill us with the love, with the joy of your love, and keep us from thoughtless prayer, lifeless singing, or wandering minds. Make our worship today a source of inspiration for us, so that we may go forth from here prepared to serve you and others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. Please take your hymnals and turn to number 73, O Worship the King. We'll sing the first two verses and then number 5. So 1, 2, and then 5 and number 73, O Worship the King. Let's stand up and worship the King.
Thank you. God is with us. Today for our ministry moment, we have Jayne Brechbill, who comes as a person who's been a part of the missions committee for a long, long time, and she's also been keenly connected to Habitat for Humanity, and we're happy to hear from her as she tells us what our May offering will be.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, Habitat. What can I say? What can I give? I have an hour, right?
Yes.
Don and I joined Habitat back in 2002 or 3. And we were working on a build for a neighbor. Talked her into talking to the Habitat people and seeing if she would qualify, and they did. And so Don was named Hammer Gun Man. You know, they gave everybody a nickname. So it was a lot of fun, and we built them a quality home. This was way back when Elizabeth Lashley, the organizer and the founder of Habitat, lived right down here, and boy, she was a go-getter. So Elizabeth and I were trying to figure out, this is early on now, we only had a few houses built. We needed the help of the churches in the area, because we just weren't getting enough income. So she said, I know, we'll have breakfast for the preachers. That'll bring them. And so at United Community Bank, I can still see her carrying her little tray of biscuits and sausage, and we met with the ministers in the area, and sure enough, the churches put us in their budget. And that's what was needed to really get this thing moving. I want to tell you just briefly, I think it was the eighth bill, I can't remember now, but it was for two children were in the family, and they were both handicapped with muscular dystrophy. And we built the house, and of course, a long ramp going up to the house. And I happened to be on dedication day. I don't know, there was a crowd, there were people everywhere. And I was on the porch, in the front porch. And I could see their faces as they were wheeling their wheelchairs up the ramp. And then they went into the house because they hadn't seen it, you know. They knew Mom and Dad had worked on it. And Mom and Dad had put each 50 sweat equity hours into that house. So they had worked on it. But the kids hadn't seen it. And so the two boys went in, and the one boy in the little wheelchair, you know, we had to make the doorways wider. Everything had to be built for wheelchair accessibility. So anyway, he wheeled himself into the living room, and he looked around, and his eyes, oh my goodness, I'll never forget it. And he went into his bedroom, Mama said. That was his bedroom. And he said, Mama, I have two plugs. Mama, I have two plugs. He meant outlets. And the other little boy said, Mama, you have a dishwasher. Oh my goodness. You can't believe the change in that family, in those children at school. They were now proud instead of feeling and being in a mold-infested trailer. So Habitat is just the best. They're having a volunteer appreciation and recruitment day on May the 2nd, coming right up, 10 to 12 in Blairsville. I'll put this announcement out there for you. But our church has given and given, and we need to keep giving, because we're building our 20th house. 20 houses. Thank you. Because I know I knew it is not going to be.
That's all right. All right.
I got it.
You got it?
Yep.
Jayne, thank you for your leadership with Habitat. Very much. For time of prayer, I've got several announcements, several things to get through, and many of them are added, so you see the names that are listed, and I certainly want you to remember these. But I also want you to know and write down the name of Mike Ackland, who is now in hospice care. This is Pam's brother, who has served this church as finance secretary for a long time. Meryl Gonto's nephew, we want to add. And late last night, we heard of Charmin Cunningham, who was rushed to the hospital. And we want to remember her in prayer as well. We are living in a day when the war and the effects of war are, we can see the details. We can hear about it. And it is horrible. I hope that you will continue to pray for peace. I hope that you will continue to pray for those that are losing family members, those that are losing their homes, those that are losing their way of life and way of peace. May we pray for them. Also would like to pray for no need for alarm. But we did want to mention it to you that today is the beginning of a new Methodist denomination. You're probably going to read about it. We wanted you to know. We know about that. You're going to read about that. But what we do want you to know, it is no cause of alarm. Sharp Memorial will continue to be Sharp Memorial. We will continue to be in ministry here and locally and around the world. We will continue to be a place of healing and wholeness. We will continue to be a place that continues in ministry. And what is happening in a creation of another denomination, it actually happens through the years. It's not something that is a surprise. I mean, so these things happen. But it will not affect us in any way. And I want you to know that. As we pray, let us remember that we sit next to a pool of tears. And so let's pray for the brothers and sisters beside us. Let's pray. God, we pray for the gift of life. And we thank you, O God, that that gift of life is here. And we can be the people that celebrate it. For every breath, O God, we thank you. For every person as a child of God, we hold precious as you do in your eyes. O God, may we sense that every encounter we have this day with others may be a holy and sacred moment where we celebrate the gift of life, where we celebrate the gift of friendship, where we celebrate the gift of love. And that every day, O God, throughout our day, may we lift it up as a gift from you because of your great care for each and every one of us. O God, you have promised to be the God that is with us. Let us be the people that are with you. And so that as we walk in times of doubt or frustration, let us claim that great divine assurance that you are with us. For all our yesterdays, let us give thanks. For every tomorrow, let us see it as a promise and hope that you are still with us. We thank you for those who you've given to our care. Each member, each person that comes in these doors, O God, may we be a gift to them as we celebrate their gift to us. May we celebrate our lives. May we celebrate your great love that unites our lives. And may we, O God, know that we do not do this, nor do you design for us to do this life on our own. You are with us. You are our God, and we are your people. And so we will be a people that will continue to pray and hearing that divine assurance to us every day that you are with us, that Jesus said, I am. And in that assurance, we know that Christ Jesus' Spirit is with us. So we pray in his name. He taught us to pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Would you all please stand for just a moment? It is our custom that when a church member passes away, that we have a moment of silence. This past week, David Huckabee passed away, and we want to recognize one who served gladly in the life of this church. He was very active in the United Methodist Men. He was very active when it was time to cook. He was active when it was time to decorate. As an older man who shouldn't be climbing ladders, he still insisted that he was going to put the star up. David Huckabee was one who loved God. And let us bow our heads for a moment of silence. Oh God, as your church, we give you thanks for each gift that you give in the people that count and make a difference for you. For they count in your great love. And for this, oh God, we thank you for David Huckabee and how he lived and served and showed his love for you and how you had your love shine through him. God, we pray a blessing upon his family in the time of loss. May there be a sense of gain in knowing that David is now in eternity with you. Lord, let it lead us as a people to move forward, knowing that we stand on the shoulders who have gone before us, and that we might be your people in our day, in our time. In Christ Jesus we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Would our ushers come forward now that we might present unto God our tithes and offerings. Let us pray. Lord, you saw a penny being given into the treasury, and you were amazed and pointed it out for your disciples. Let every single gift, O God, be a blessing and praise to you. For as we give, O God, it is because you have first given to us. Amen. Thank you.
Would our child come forward for children's time? Maybe. Maybe come. I got candy. I want you also to know that something really special happened this week in the life of the church. And a lot of times it's me getting to represent you all. The the whole administrative council decided to build a roof for a needy person. And I want to thank you for your wonderful giving to make that a possibility. I also want to thank you, too, that when you gave, you also this week turned the lights on for two people. And so I'm very grateful for your giving in the life of this church.
Good morning. How are you? How are you doing? I'm glad you're here. Do you like butterflies? Oh, I do too. Do you have some around your house? Do you? Do you like yellow ones? Look, do you like a yellow one? Do you like yellow? What about a green one? And that's a sticker, and so you could put... Do you want a purple one? Yeah, you do. Okay. That's so good. I like that. Which one is more important? Which one would you get? Do you know? Is that one more valuable? Or is that one more valuable? Is one of them better? Is one of them better than the other? You think that one's better? Do you know what's God? They're all equal. Every one of these, look at these. I've even got some more in here. Every one of these are special. Look at that. Look at this one. Do you like an orange? It's a little one, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's not as big as the others. But does it make it better than the others? No. It's important too. You know, I want you to know that you are just as important to God as anybody else in this room. You are loved by God.
Look at that smile.
Yes. Yes, you are loved. You are. You are loved, and I want you to, every time you come into this place, and every time you go anywhere, I want you to know that God is with you, and that is because God loves you. Isn't it good to be with Mommy? Do you like being with Mommy and Daddy?
Yeah.
Yep. And you know why? It's because they love you. They love you. God is with you too, and God loves you. I hope you will live your life, and you will never, ever forget that. Let's pray. God, thank you for loving each and every one of us, from the old to the young, to the smallest to the biggest. Your love is great every day. Amen. Amen. I'm glad you came today. It's so good to be with you. Yay. And listen, I thought this had candy in it. Let me go get some candy. Well, I see this one, and I'm thinking, gosh, does he want a sucker? Maybe he wants one of these. So we got, look at this. All right. Do you want, which one do you like?
That one.
Okay. All right. Good.
That one.
Okay. Take one for you, okay, and then I want you to take another one. And then you take another one because you're going to give it away. Okay, take another one. All right? And you're going to give that to somebody, okay?
It's Daddy.
Okay, give it to Daddy. Boy. Isn't that the way it goes? Mama does all the work and Daddy gets the candy. Glad you're here. Congratulations, Daddy.
Our hymn of preparation is In the Faith We Sing. That's that little book underneath you in front of you. And it's number 2146, His Eye is on a Sparrow. We'll sing the first verse of His Eye is on a Sparrow. So let's stand and sing together.
My sheep, I feel distracted.
It's good to be back. I thank you very much for the privilege that you give me to go and celebrate birthdays in my family. And when there are celebrations of one's 90th birthday, it doesn't happen often. So we are grateful. This time, Melanie and I decided we'd fly. We had enough frequent flyer miles that we decided to fly and, you know, to be able to arrive there rested. So we got up at 3 o'clock in the morning to make it down for a 6:30 flight out of Atlanta. And, you know, that was okay. I mean, it wasn't the best. But then coming back, we had a leisurely time of getting up at, you know, being at the airport at 9 o'clock. We only had to go a little ways. And, you know, the plane was supposed to leave at 11 o'clock that Monday afternoon. And we were there till 1 p.m., 4 p.m., 5 p.m., 8 p.m., 10 p.m., and then finally at 10:30 at night, almost 13 and a half hours later, we leave the Austin airport to come to Atlanta, then to get to the car, and then drive back to Young Harris, arriving at 5 a.m. Tuesday morning. So it was a very restful trip. I think Melanie will say that we're both still recovering, but that's all right. It's still good to be home. It's good, always good to be home, is it not? I want to read some portions of Scripture that maybe you've heard before. I'm tying these together because through the month of May, we're going to have a sermon series about every piece counts. You will actually be mailed a puzzle piece, one per family, household, and in that, we are hoping that you will bring it back on May 22nd. On May 22nd, we will meet over at the college campus in a place where we can all meet together at 10 o'clock in the morning. One service that day, one church, and we'll gather together at Sharp Memorial, and we'll put together that puzzle. We're actually also going to be mailing out a puzzle piece to all our children, and so we want them to have one to be able to put together as well. In leading up to that day, I want you to hear that every piece counts. Every person counts. From Matthew chapter 10, beginning with verse 29. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet none of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs on your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. From Luke chapter 12, beginning with verse 6. Are not five sparrows sold for two pennies? You notice how the value went down. Yet not one of them is forgotten in God's sight. But even the hairs on your head are all counted. Do not be afraid, for you are of more value than many sparrows. And then from John chapter 15, beginning with verse 4. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them will bear much fruit. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. From Ezekiel, we find these words. My dwelling place shall be with them, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. Throughout all of human history, the voice of God resounds with an absolute assurance. I am with you. This good news is proclaimed in our worship. It is found written in our affirmations of faith. It is found over and over again in our scriptures. But more importantly, God's divine assurance of I am with you is a reality that unfolds before us through actual experiences of individuals and families from nations and across generations. To Isaac, God said, "Do not be afraid, for I am with you and I will bless you." To Joshua, God said, "I will be with you as I was with Moses." To the disciples, Jesus said, "And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." To Paul, God said, "Don't be afraid to speak, and do not be silent, for I am with you." And probably my favorite moments of recognizing, of being with God's presence, is the resurrection story found in the Gospel of John, in which Jesus says to Mary, "Why are you weeping? And whom are you looking for?" Mary turns to this man standing close by, and mistaking him to be the gardener, Mary begs him to tell her if he has moved the body, of which Jesus responds by calling her name, Mary. And Mary's heartbreak turns to joy. The Bible does not simply tell us of the presence of God. It shows us the active presence of God deeply and permanently embedded in human life. Across thousands of years, with wave upon wave of names and faces and recurring events, the Bible threads God's patient words for each and every one of us. I am with you. Consider the words of Jesus found on the front of your bulletin. From the Gospel of John, Jesus describes himself through these I am statements. I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the good shepherd. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the gate. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the vine. In these images of Jesus, we can experience the divine assurance, I am with you. In these images, we can feed our faith and grow our trust in God's divine assurance, I am with you. And in these images of Jesus, we can also hear a divine invitation. The I will be with you becomes, will you be with me? God's love is not forced on us. From the beginning story of Adam and Eve, God makes clear to us that we have the freedom to choose a life with God or choose against a life with God. Do you recall that story of Adam and Eve when they chose to be against life with God and they decided they would do things on their own? Do you remember that part of the story where God came after them while they were hiding? We too can choose a life apart from God in our attempts to be God, to seek to master life on our and the world on our own. But God chooses to be with us in spite of our flights to try to be God and to do life on our own. And God, the great initiator, becomes God, the great pursuer. From Romans, we find these words and recall, But God proves God's love for us while we were yet sinners. Christ died for us. Life with God does not depend upon our own efforts, on our own successes, or even failures. Grace is God's love of the I am with you. Grace is God's love of I am with you still. Grace is God's love of I am with you, will you be with me? Do you recall that time of love? Do you recall that time of love? I was present. I was with her, but I could tell she wasn't with me. I remember another time. I was with her. I was all in, and she was with me. And I married her. More valuable, for sure, than 2 or 5 sparrows. More known than the number of hairs on your head. More connected, you think, as the vine is to the branch. Yes, every piece counts in a puzzle to complete the full picture. Every person counts to God, for God's love escapes no one. Every person has a place at God's table of love. Richard Foster says, ultimately, belief in Jesus is a resting heart. I am yours, and you are mine. God's divine assurance is also at the same time God's divine invitation. I am with you calls to trust. I am with you calls you and I to live in love with God. I am with you calls with a divine assurance and a divine invitation. This life-giving God begins the story with you and I with a very simple yet profound beginning. I am with you. May it be something we never forget. May it be something we hold on to all of our days. And may we answer it with, Lord, I want to be with you. Let's pray. God, we thank you for the gift of your assurance of life. And we thank you for the invitation to be a part of that life in a deeper way. Lord, as we come to your table, may we answer that call to be with you. Amen. Would you turn to page 12 in your hymnals and let us join together in the prayer of confession and pardon. The great I am says, I am with you. You are invited. Let us unite together. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. Let us unite in the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here. And on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Would those assisting with communion come forward at this time? When we break the bread, is it not our participation in the brokenness and love that God has for each and every one of us? And when we share in the cup, is it not our participation in God's love for each and every one of us? This is the Lord's table. It's not a Methodist or a members' table only. It is for all, each and every one. After, if you would come forward as the ushers escort you down the center aisle and filling in the sides, and then returning by the side aisle.
I am the good
good shepherd. I am is with you with a great love to live life fully and holy. And for that, oh God, we give you thanks and praise and seek to follow you with all our heart this day forward. Amen. Cheapen the life for even sparrows that weren't worth but a penny were valued by God. And may we turn to each other with a love that says you are counted. You are among the children of God. If today you wish to make a profession of faith, which you have not made in your life, I invite you to come as God's Spirit leads you. And if today you wish to come and join this church, I invite you to come as we stand and sing our final hymn.
It's the insert in your bulletin, In Christ There Is No Easter Wellness. We will sing the first two verses and then number 4. I will see to you after because the ladies of the choir are coming in to sing. So verses 1, 2, and 4 of your insert, let's stand and sing together.
and to the big choir, each voice, please stand for the benediction. This I know with all my heart, his wounds have paid my ransom. This I know with all my heart, that God has been with us yesterday and is with us today and will be with you now and forevermore. Amen.
Please sing with us.